In this video, we are going to learn how to use shapes in Figma Design. The shape tools we will cover today, rectangles, ellipses, polygons, and stars, allow you to create scalable, high-quality vector graphics that never lose clarity or quality, unlike those pixel-based images of JPEGs or PNGs. So whether you're designing a simple icon for a class project, a checkout button for an element of your mobile app prototype, or even a geometric avatar for your friend, these fundamental shapes provide endless possibilities for creativity. So further in this video, we'll explore how to use these tools effectively through a handful of interactive activities. To follow along in your own Figma file, please click on the link in the video description below. Let's begin. For this first activity, hover down to the page titled 1, How to Add Shapes. Now go down over to the toolbar and you're gonna select where the rectangle is and click on rectangle. We're gonna add a rectangle just by left clicking and dragging and dropping that by letting go on the canvas. Go ahead and click on the rectangle again. This time, hold down shift. When I hold down shift, I can make a straight square. Another way to add shapes to your canvas, or in this case, to this section, is to click on a shape and hit control D. You'll see that rectangle 3 is added. I can hold shift and just drag it right down below. Let's go ahead and add another. Click on the toolbar in the shapes tool. Click on ellipse. Let's hold down shift and make this quite large. Now, one thing you can recognize is that over here on the right-hand side, I can start changing dimensions. I can change the dimensions by typing in 444 for the width. I can also go ahead and scrub by left-clicking and dragging this, looking excellent. Next, I'm gonna go ahead and click on the shapes tool again. You'll see the most recent one is the ellipse. I'm gonna click on star, my favorite one, hold down shift, and just add it here. Now on some of these shapes, you'll see there are these little buttons here. We're gonna explore those a little bit later, so just ignore them for now. Go ahead and one more time, click here, and just go one up and add the polygon. Hold down shift here, and there we go. Now that you've added your first shapes, let's go ahead and click on page 2, editing rectangles and circles. Let's first learn the editing properties of the shapes, and then play around with colors and other effects. For this first one, go ahead and click here, and we're gonna see that we can actually soften the radius. Looking pretty good. Let's move over here. I can double click here. See, I can move this item right here, which is a vector point. Let's snap it back here. And let's change the corner radius to 100. Let's actually change it to maybe 200. And that's looking like a nice slice of cheese. Let's go over here and try that again. But this time, I'm going to hold down shift while selecting these three vector points. Let's change this to be 200 as well. And that's looking pretty cool. If I click on this shape or click back, and then go to the top right corner or any corner of this shape, I can now move that. And this kind of looks like an icon I'd find on a map. This next one, let's try this by double clicking, hold down shift, and let's go ahead and change the corner radius. I'm gonna hold down shift while changing the corner radius and make it something like this, above 200. Next, click control D while selecting rectangle 4, hold shift, and you can actually rotate this out. I can left click over both of those, hit control D again to duplicate, and make an entirely new shape. How neat. On this next one, let's go ahead and see how we can add color. Let's make a slight little edit. There we go. Click on the shape, or if it's already selected, go down to fill. And let's change this to be a nice looking red. Awesome. One thing I can also do is if I zoom out and look at all the other shapes that I have made so far, I can left click over all of them. And I can also change them to that color. Nice, looking pretty neat. Let's move down to the ellipses. I'm gonna zoom in here. Click on the ellipse and you can change the arc. Go up here to the top and let's tilt that over here and make it a nice yellow. Awesome, pack person. Over here, click on the arc, then go ahead and change the ratio and bring that sweep back. Let's make this into a nice blue. There we go. Let's click on this shape, go ahead and change the arc, and let's change the ratio, and then let's go ahead and tilt it to make a nice looking C. Let's change this one to be somewhat of a purple. All right, I'm happy with that. Next one, this is my favorite. Let's go ahead and double click. Let's click on this right here, and let's just make an egg. Excellent, let's go with kind of a green eggs and ham feel. Amazing. On this last one, I'm gonna go ahead and double click, and I'm gonna click on a vector point. You can see that I have these handles. When I have the handles, I can also hold down shift to snap them in 15 degree increments. I can start making some really neat designs. Click on the handle and you can change those designs right here. Another thing you can do is after selecting a shape and double clicking into it, you can click on the bend tool. The bend tool allows you to move different parts of those lines in that vector path. go ahead and click out. You can change it a color if you want to and edit any of these shapes as you would like. Alrighty, let's go ahead and move on to editing stars and polygons. Let's zoom into this one and you can add colors later, but I'm going to keep mine this simple gray. Click on the first polygon, click it again, and go ahead and change the count. Next, go to the second star, change the count, and this time go ahead and change the ratio. Cool. This one, let's change the count. Let's say to 16. Change the ratio up to above 70%. And now change the radius down to about 14. And when you do that, you can edit the count again, and those other properties will stay. After this, let's go ahead and click on this one, but double click into it. This is for star number 4. What you'll do here is go ahead and left click and select these top 4 inner vector points. Hold down shift and hit delete. You can make an entirely new shape by shift deleting a vector point within a path. All right, let's move over to the polygons. Click the polygon to where you see the count and you'll see the count change. Here you can also see the bounding box of that shape so that you don't go beyond it. Let's click here. Let's change the count again and let's soften the radius a bit. Let's change the count to about, let's say, 7. Double click the shape now. Left click over the top 3 vector points, hit shift delete, and you made a nice parallelogram. Maybe not parallelogram. What is this, a trapezoid? I don't know. Do note that when you change the property like this, you'll no longer be able to edit the shape's count like you can in this previous shape. Lastly, let's go ahead and double click on this triangle. And as you zoom in, you'll see that a predictive vector point appears and you now have the pen tool. Let's go ahead and bump this in right here. Let's go to my corner radius. Let's change this to 300. Now we have a nice looking shark fin. I'm not going to go and change my colors, but definitely go over to your page 2, take anything you applied here and apply it to the colors as well as the effects on these shapes. Now let's move over to building with shapes. On this page, we'll use shapes to make these 2 birds. Zoom in and grab yourself an ellipse. Hold down shift and make it exactly 200. Make sure to lock aspect ratio. From here, go ahead and click on the arc tool while also holding down shift and snap it to 62.5. I'm going to click on the fill, actually grab the eyedropper and change it to be the exact one right here. Next, let's move this down. Go ahead and grab a square, hold down shift and make this with locking aspect ratio exactly 100. Grab that and place it on top of the body of the duck. Double click, grab this vector point and change this to be 100. Looking pretty snazzy. Click on the fill, click on the eyedropper, change to green. For this next one, grab this existing shape, hit Control D and let's scale this down to 50. Move the shape out, hold down shift, and let's change it to that nice yellow. There we go. Grab an ellipse, hold down shift. Let's make this one exactly 20. Click on the fill, make it black, and add the eyeball wherever you'd like. Looking pretty good. Let's make this parrot. Click your shapes tools, select rectangle, hold down shift, lock aspect ratio, and set to 100. Next, let's change this to be that kind of orangish pink, and let's move it right down here. Next, I'm going to hit Control D. Move one over here, double click, select this vector point, change to 100. I'm going to select this shape, hit Control D, bring it up here, hover over the corner, hold down shift, rotate it like so. Let's go ahead and grab this shape right here, hit Control D, bring it up over here, make sure aspect ratio is locked, change to 75, hit enter. Let's change this to yellow. This will become the beak. Select the shape, hold down shift, bring it up over here. Zoom on in, grab this shape, hit Control D, changes to be 25 with aspect ratio locked. Make sure you know where that is. Select this to be black. And let's click on here and rotate ever so slightly and tuck in right there. Select the ellipse tool, hold down shift, lock aspect ratio, set to 100, change the arc to be 50, change this to white, right click to flatten the shape, rotate ever so slightly and snap right there. Grab your ellipse tool, hold down shift, lock aspect ratio, set to 20, change the fill to black, and move where you think fits best. Look at these birds. Now both of them have a buddy. Let's move to Shapes Playground. Shapes Playground, well, is a playground of possibilities. And I'm actually not going to show you how to make these designs. I believe that you know everything you need to know to make these designs and really have fun in this space. So I have some inspiration here. You can actually click on any one of these shapes, move them around, get some insight into how they were made, see the actual dimensions, and you have a blank space over here called, well, your playground space. Go ahead and start designing, grab any inspiration from the existing shapes or anything else you see in this file. And with that, have a good time. Happy designing.